What body odour can teach us about Maslow's hierarchy of needs? Well, under my armpits I have small holes and hair, and during the day I keep my arms by my side all day and they get warm, and the sweat that comes out of the holes mingles with the hair and breeds bacteria and begins to smell. Let's call that body odour. Now, what I can do about that is I can spray something on which blocks the holes, and that stops the sweat coming out in the first place. We'll call that an antiperspirant. Or what I could do is I could get another spray and spray it on top of my original smell. Now, it doesn't stop the smell, it just masks it, because the smell I spray on is even stronger than my own body odour. We'll call that a deodorant. Now, am I selling this to you? Am I making it sound attractive? I have rationally explained the function of both a deodorant and an antiperspirant, and you'll probably pay me, say, a dollar for either. What I could do, of course, is I could tell you that by doing that, I'm going to make you sexually voraciously attractive to the opposite sex for the next 48 hours, so you're batting them off with a stick. And we'll call that the Lynx effect or the Axe effect. And I won't just call it a deodorant, I'll call it gravity or Africa. Now, it's exactly the same thing, except what I've done is I've escalated the benefit from function to emotion, just as Maslow explained in his hierarchy of needs. And now you'll pay me $3. $3 for exactly the same thing. When it comes to value proposition creation, we always need to understand that we should present the benefit both functionally and emotionally. Functionally, rationally, what does the customer get? But also emotionally, what's the emotional consequence or reward of that function?